Today in this session, we talk about numbers that we use in our daily life in the form of time, distance, size, weight, etc. So today we shall start chapter 1, number system of 9th class. Before starting this chapter, I will introduce you about the different number system with the help of this diagram. First category is natural numbers. These numbers are called natural numbers because they occur naturally in the nature. These numbers are known as counting number. These numbers start from 1, 2, 3, 4 up to so on. So smallest natural number is 1. After that, the second category is whole numbers. When zero is included in natural numbers, these numbers become whole number. Means whole number collection is bigger than natural number. If I say zero is a natural number? No, zero is not a natural number. Zero is not a natural number. We cannot say every whole number is a natural number. We can say every natural number is a whole number. Every natural number is a whole number because whole number collection is bigger than natural number. After that, third category is integer. Integers are the collection of positive and natural numbers. These are the collection of positive and negative numbers. So here the collection is bigger than whole number and natural number. So we can say that every natural number is an integer. 2 is an integer, we can say 2 is an integer because 2 is present in the collection of integer. For example, every whole number is an integer. For example, if I say 4 is an integer, yes, 4 is an integer because 4 is present in the collection of integer. On the other hand, if I say minus 2 is a whole number, is it possible minus 2 is a whole number? No, it is not possible that minus 2 is a whole number because minus 2 does not belong to the category of the whole number. After integers, there are some numbers which can be written in the form of numerator upon denominator. These numbers are known as rational numbers, in which we can write in the form of numerator upon denominator, and denominator should not be equal to 0. So example is given to you. Minus 1 by 2, 3 by 5, 4 by 5, 6 by 7. These numbers should be integers. Minus 1 should be integer. Means P, rational number are those numbers which can be written in the form of P over Q. Like these numbers we have written. After that, the collection. Here, another collection is there. Irrational number. You can think why these numbers are separate from these numbers. This is the question. Irrational number, these all we have seen. First natural number is there, then whole number is there, then integer is there, rational number is there. And why it's so irrational number is different from these numbers? It is different because irrational numbers are those numbers which cannot be written in the form of P over Q. Under root 2, under root 3, under root 5. All are the irrational numbers which cannot be written in the form of P over Q, as under root 2 does not belong to category of these numbers. After that, irrational number. When we combine irrational number and rational number, the new numbers, we get real numbers. The collection of irrational number and irrational numbers, we get real numbers. Why these are numbers are known as real numbers? Because we can plot these numbers on the number line. That is why these numbers are known as real number. So the next is the very quick repeat of these definitions. Classifications of number. First is natural number. The natural number starting from 1, 2, 3, 4. These are used for counting. After that whole numbers. Whole numbers, when zero include in this collection, then it becomes whole numbers. That means 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. These numbers, this collection is known to be our whole number. After that, integers, the collection of positive and negative numbers are integers. So, it is a collection of positive and negative numbers. After that, rational number. The numbers which can be written in the form of P over Q, where P and Q are integers and Q does not belong to 0. For example, 2 by 3, minus 5 by 2 and 7 by 9, etc. Let us take an example. Can we see 2 upon 0 is a rational number? 2 upon 0 is a rational number or not? No. The answer to this question is no. 2 by 0 is not a rational number because denominator should not be 0. So after that, the next collection is irrational number. Those numbers which cannot be written in the form of P over Q are known as irrational number. For example, under root 2, under root 3, under root 5, etc. These are the irrational number. After that, the last category, real numbers. Last but not least, one is another, but we only discuss these numbers. Real numbers, the collection of both rational numbers and irrational numbers are called real numbers. So this is all about the different types of number. First, natural numbers are there. After that, whole numbers, integers, rational numbers, irrational numbers, and real numbers. Now the next is exercise. Now coming to the exercise number 1.1. First question is 0 is a rational number? Can you write in the form of P over Q, where P and Q are integers and Q is not equal to 0? The question is 0 is a rational number? Is 0 is a rational number? The solution to this question is yes, 0 is a rational number. Why is it so? Because we can write 0 in the form of 0 upon 1. 0 upon 2, 0 upon 3, 0 upon 4 and so on. So 0 is a rational number. But can we write 0 upon 0? Can we write 0 upon 0? No, we cannot write 0 upon 0. If we write so, then 0 will not a rational number. That will not a rational number because the condition, you have to remember the condition. You have to remember the condition that denominator should not be 0. Okay. The second question is, find the 6 rational numbers between 3 and 4. For finding 6 rational numbers between 3 and 4, we write 3 and 4 as a rational numbers with denominators. For this, we have given that we have to find 6 rational numbers. So, add 1, 6 plus 1 equals to 7. That is, we shall multiply and divide the given number with 7. 3 multiplied by 7 divided by 7. So, number will be 21 upon 7. On the same lines, 4 again multiply and divide the given number with 7. So we will get 28 upon 7. So 6 rational numbers between 3 and 4 are 22 by 7, 23 by 7, 24 upon 7, 25 upon 7, 26 upon 7, and 27 upon 7. Again, what we have to do if we want to find six rational numbers. So multiply and divide the given number with 6 plus 1 equals to 7. So it will be 7 divided by 7. That is 21 upon 7. 4 multiply by 7 and divide by 7. We get 28 by 7. So 6 rational numbers between 3 and 4 are 22 by 7, 23 by 7, 24 by 7, 25 by 7, 26 by 7 and 27 by 7. For example, if we want to find 5 rational numbers, then what we have to do, we have to multiply the given numbers with 5 plus 1, that is 6. We have to multiply the given number with 6 and 6, 6 over 6. So the next question is find the 5 rational numbers between 3 by 5 and 4 by 5. Again we can now to find 5 rational numbers between 3 by 5 and 4 by 5. For this, we will convert these numbers into decimal. 3 by 5 will be 0.6 and 4 by 5 is 0.8. Now, we have to write the decimal numbers. We have to write these numbers between 0.6 and 0.8. These numbers are 0.61, 0.62, 0.63 and 0.64 and 0.65. We can also apply the method which you apply in the second sum. Here you can see we have 5 rational numbers. So we have to make the denominators 5 plus 1, that is 6. Multiply and divide by 6. So we get, if we want to multiply with this 6, we get 18 by 30. And here we will get 24 upon 30. So we can write the numbers between them. The second method also applicable to this sum also. But this is another method. For this, firstly you have to convert these numbers into decimals. After that, write the rational numbers between them. The last question is, you have to tell that given statement is false or true, and you have to mention the reason also. The first question is, first statement is, every natural number is a whole number. That is, we have to say that every natural number is a whole number or not. Of course, this is true. Every natural number is a whole number. As we can see from the diagram, every natural number is a whole number. From this diagram we can say yes, it is true, that is every natural number is a whole number, because whole collection of natural number is contained in whole numbers. So every natural number is a whole number. So reason is also that the collection of whole numbers contains all the natural number. The second is, every integer is a whole number. Every integer is a whole number. And I have already explained to you every integer. Because every integer is a whole number. Is it possible that every integer is a whole number? The answer is false. It is not possible that every integer is a whole number. Let us take an example. If minus 2, if we take, minus 2 is not a whole number, because minus 2 does not belong to the collection of the whole number. That's why every integer is not a whole number. But and to conclude with that, every whole number is a integer. We can see from the diagram, it is very much clear that this minus 2 does not belongs to whole number. That means minus 2 is not an integer. Every integer is not a whole number. You can always see this diagram. Each and everything is contained in another. For example, whole number is natural number is contained in whole number is contained in integers is contained in the rational numbers. This is very interlinked diagram. So the next question is, every rational number is a whole number. Again we can say minus 1 upon 2 is a rational number but not a whole number. The same reason is that minus 1 by 2 does not belong to category of the whole number. Okay, minus 1 by 2 does not contain any fraction number. We can have minus, if we say 0.5, does it present in a whole number? No. Means every rational number is not a whole number. But to conclude with that, every whole number is a rational number. We can write 2 as a rational number, 2 upon 1. We can write 0 as a rational number, as 0 is a whole number, we can write it as a rational number, as we have seen in the example 1. Sum number 1, we have seen that 0 is a rational number. So this is all about this exercise 1.1. So to recapitulate today, what we have done in this session, we have classified the number system, how number system classify. First, natural number is there, whole number is there, integers, then rational number. To conclude with this session, we can say this real numbers is the combination of irrational number and rational numbers.